Rivers now to throw on first down. Deep drop. And he's going to go down way back at the 42-yard line.
Well, how about that? A dime set on defense. Six defensive backs. None of them blitz. They're just back there in coverage. Defensive lineman gets the sack.
That's where the O-line, they go to the sideline. They keep their helmets on so the cameras can't find them, right?
Yeah, the cameras can't find them, but I know one thing. The O-line coach will.
And some changes here as the D-line separates some. Second down, Rivers. And this is going to be intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And some room to maneuver. There he goes, left side. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Raider defense delivers a score.
That was an interception, but on the field, the guys who are picking it off, they're not saying that. What word are they using? It's Oski. And that means catch the ball and go the other way.
That's your vernacular. I've never heard anybody say Oski.
Ask around. They'll tell you.
The try here for the extra point. And it is up. And it's good. That'll make our score 10-3 now. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. And now San Diego getting set to go. Down, Rivers. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. It'll go as a gain of 12, and that'll be good for a San Diego first down. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. On first and 10, Rivers. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff, didn't
they? Yeah, when we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, you know, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time, really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on.
Got a man over the middle. It's Williams. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue.
So on that play, defense was in the zone. They ran a crossing route offensively, but the defense there, you got to be good with communication, don't you?
You certainly do, and it's not something that is really evident when you watch it on the screen. But everyone's talking, communicating, pointing, and it keeps you from chasing receivers because you have a specific zone you have to cover. When a receiver's in your zone and he crosses to another one, you got to let your guy know. They got a completion there, but I like the discipline they show to stay in their proper areas and then make the tackle.
Second down following the run. They keep it on the ground. Again, Gordon. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains.
It's nice every now and then in this game not to see people overthink it. Just hand it to the old reliable guy. Let him pick up the first down.
So the D-line's going to spread out. Now a play fake here on first down. Under pressure and down he goes. They sack him back at the 36.
You know, on these types of plays, we're always looking to assess blame. Okay, where did it break down? Sometimes it's just a great play.
The offense certainly looking to score some points, but they also need ball security here late as we get down to the final moments of this one. And the back goes into motion. The play clock's running down.
Rivers now on second down. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. And he goes in motion here in the backfield. Third and long for Rivers. This is caught inside the 15. A pickup of 24 on the third down conversion. And this will probably be the final play before the two-minute warning. Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. One man in the backfield is Gordon. Rivers on first down. And this is complete. It's Allen. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. Simple slant route, and Parter, really nice hard throw by the quarterback.
Nice timing between the quarterback and the receiver. They were perfectly in sync, and he put it right on him on the inside route.
And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. He lost 2 there, and it's third down.
The insistence of speed at every position is really seen at the defensive end spot. These guys in the old days were often outside linebackers. They just pushed them forward because they wanted to play fast and get to the quarterback or the running backs quicker than ever before.
Back to throw. He's got time in the pocket. And he's got the rookie Henry for a Charger touchdown. Henry, his 3rd touchdown now on the year. And the Chargers are an extra point away from tying this thing up. And no sweat, he puts it through, and we are tied here in the 4th. Set to go now with the kickoff. These two teams all even again as we continue in this wild 4th quarter. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. And now over. Ready to take the field. They've got work to do, but they do still have a bit of time here.
And they've got to feel comfortable with that, but they have all their play sequences called. If they get out of bounds, that allows them to huddle and call another play, but if they don't, it's hurry up to the line of scrimmage and either spike it and stop the clock or continue to move it downfield in order to try and get in range and win this game.
See if they can do just that. To throw. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. It's a gain of 24 that time. And the Raiders are going to have a first down. And they're going to speed things up here. To throw is Bortles. And this is going to be intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line. Here comes the Chargers offense now back out onto the field. They need to get this around the 40 on the other side to get into field goal range. Look at the clock, a decent amount of time here in a tie game. What do they do?
No panic situation at all. They've got to get a couple of chunk plays, pick up nice bits of yardage.
Target the sidelines.
Target the sidelines because you want to get out of bounds and make sure that clock stops. Because if the clock stays running, that makes things that much tougher for you. It can always bleed out on you.
It's caught on the right side, Williams. They got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. So here we go, first and 10 now. Here's Rivers. Throw right side, complete to Williams. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15, just shy of the 10. A gain of 32 that time.
A lot of receivers see the drag route as a risk-reward type of a play. The risk, going into the middle of the field where there's some big people who want to hit you.
And he's in for the touchdown. And in the final seconds, forget overtime. They've just likely won this thing in regulation.
Well, any thoughts about overtime have ended at this juncture. That touchdown puts them up 6. I would imagine they'll kick the extra point now and rely on their defense.
Yeah, rely on their defense. So a little bit of time left on the clock here in the fourth, but they got to feel good now. And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to come out is going to cost him 5 yards with a new rule as he's taken down right at the 20-yard line. Now the Oakland offense heading back onto the field to take over. Critical condition here, obviously. Got to hope to get something quick right and then maybe take that shot deep.
And once they do take the big shot, you've got to worry on defense. Of course, no one getting behind the defense to make it an easy throw. But nowadays, it's not just the ball being tipped in the air and people in the end zone in a cluster. It's that guy that's short of the end zone who comes up and ends up making the play because he goes unguarded. So there's a lot to think about if you're playing defense in this situation.
We'll see if they can cover all their bases. One final try now for Bortles. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And it's incomplete. So their final drive comes up empty. And with that, the ball game is over. Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play. We're still, you're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.
So for San Diego, they move back over 500 at 3-2 now on the year. And they'll be back home next week to take on the Denver Broncos. Meanwhile, for Oakland, it was a good first month, but they'll fall to 4-1 as they suffer their first loss. And they'll get a home date next week against the Kansas City Chiefs.